Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to giving a demo of magnetic field measurement instrument. This is an instrument by which you can study the magnetic field distribution of magnetic field through a current carrying conductor or a coil, to be exact. The order code for this magnetic field measurement apparatus is 55524. You can use this order code to check the specification about it and to use and to purchase by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So basically, magnetization or magnetic field is generated when a current passing through any conductor. So when the current passes through any conductor, the magnetic field around the conductor is generated. For this, the current carrying coils, to be exact, we are using a circular coil in which we will providing a current of fixed amount, then by a constant current source, then the magnetic field will be generated around the coil, and then we measure the correlation with the distance with the other coil or with the effect of different current produces. So by this we will follow different types of experiment considering with this apparatus. So using this experimental setup of magnetic field measurement, you can calculate the correlation of the magnetic field with the distance along the axis of center of the coil. Also, you can study the superposition of the magnetic field with the other coil, and also we will check the diameter of the coil by using calculating the magnetic field with this apparatus. And also we will study the relation between current and magnetic field at the center of any coil. So we are now going to perform the experiment. Before that, we will explain the all parts of this apparatus. So in this part, there are two parts are included, which is the magnetic field measurement instrument, then a Helmholtz coil, and a sensor for measurement of magnetic field. So we will start describing all the parts one by one. First of all, we have a magnetic field measurement apparatus. In this is a 2 meters. First one is to measure the gauge or the magnetic field range, and the other one is display for the current which we are going to provide it. We can provide current from 0 to 500 milliampere by this current adjusting knob. And the line regulation for this is plus minus 2% for plus minus 10% of main variation. Load regulation is also 0.2% for no load and to full load. There are 2 display of 3.5 digit 7-segment LED, and the complete setup works on the 220 volt power supply, plus minus 10% in the 50 hertz power supply, and also protected against the overload and short circuit protection. And this is the zero adjustment knob for adjusting the zero of magnetic field, to be exact measurement. And this is the connector for connecting the magnetic sensor, by which we can calculate the exact value of magnetic field. And this is the connector for providing the supply or the constant current to the coils. These are the selector switches. We can select one coil, coil number 2, or we can select both coil on working to provide the supply on the coils. So this is the main operation bench at which we are going to perform the different operation or the practicals. It has 2 coils. One is fixed coil and the other one is the coil that can be moved smoothly along the axis, which is the bench, and with the scale of 1000 mm is provided, about 1 meter. And this is the stand for sensor, and the sensor is connected on the stand. The complete length of the sensor is 265 mm to the center. The length is required when we calculate the distance with the coil, and the radius of these coils are 112 mm, and the number of turns of each coils having 500 turns of each coil. Sensor could be read on the scale easily by positioning it any of the position. The user manual consists all the required information regarding the apparatus and also about the practicals that we are going to do with this. And now we are going to follow the experiment procedure to find out the different values and to perform the all experiments, including this kit. The brief theory about the magnetic field measurement apparatus and the basic concepts are provided in the user manual. The brief theory: as the VIP theory, we know that the intensity of magnetic field on the basis of Biot-Savart law at the point P lying on the axis of a circular coil AB of the radius A, having n turns at the distance x from the center O of the coil in the SI units, is given by B equals to mu naught upon 4 pi into 2 pi n I a square upon a square plus x square whole root 3 by 2 Tesla. This is the basic formula to calculate the magnetic field, and this is the basic representation of magnetic field circular. This is our coil at which the magnetic field is generated. The radius of this coil is A from center to the A point, and this is the distance at which we are checking the magnetic field using the sensor. So this is the distance that can be varies, and the magnetic field distance center of the coil graph is showing here. So by this graph, if we move away from the zero towards the right or left, the intensity of the magnetic field decreases, as a graph showing the relation between the intensity of the magnetic field B and the distance of the X is given using this figure. The curve of the first is concave towards the O, but the curvature becomes less and less, quickly changes the sign at P point and Q point, after becomes the convex towards zero. So this is the point at which the magnetic field is highest, and at this point the distance from the center of the coil is almost equal to the radius of the coil. So this is the experiment or concept that we are going to verify using this apparatus. This is the panel diagram which is given in the user manual to arrange the setup accordingly. This is the scale. They are the two Helmholtz coil that we are using for the magnetic field generation. This is the sensor. Sensor is at the point, and the sensor rod is of 265 mm, as I also talked earlier. These are all the movable stand. The first coil is fixed. We cannot move the first coil. Just we can move it into a little fractions, and we have to put the first coil at the fixed position. Then we move the second coil and check other experiments. This is the magnetic field apparatus. You can use this magnetic field apparatus to calculate the Gauss or the intensity of the magnetic field and current to provide the coils. So this is the complete setup. You need to set up the experiment bench like this. For the ease of students, we have provided this panel. Now we are going to perform the experiment 1. The experiment 1 is to study the axial variation of magnetic field due to a single coil, calculate the radius of the coil, and to study the equals to the radius proceeds as follows. These are the complete step by step following procedure. I will explain you how to connect the sensor and all the different values or the coils, and then we perform the practical and take down the readings. By this we will then do the graph. So now we are going to follow the procedure. For this we have to first connect the sensor cable with this 3-pin connector to the sensor socket, and coil cable with the 4-point connector to the coil socket. So this is the sensor cable that I am going to connect at the 3-pin socket. Properly align the socket and then tighten the screw for holding this, and the coil connector should need to be also connected. This is a 4-point connector, and properly align connector with the groove and connect. So this is our first connection. Now we will switch on the mains power using the on-off switch, and after switching on the power we can see display on the both meters. Then the current adjusting knob anti-clockwise should be at the minimum position so that current is reduced to zero. So our knob is almost at the zero point, so current is zero, and when we increase it to clockwise, the current will be increased gradually. Now We need to keep the sensor at minus 80 mm, then adjust the Gauss meter to the zero with this zero adjustment knob. So the scale need to be calibrated according to this, as the point of sensor is from distance of 265 mm, because the distance of this rod is 265 mm from the center point of this sensor. We can use the coil by this movable spring coils, and for a perfect measurement I have put the coil 1, which is the fixed coil, is at the 30 mm position. So the mark can be matched by the scale, which is the 30 mm position. Now we will move the sensor stand, and using a scale you can use minus 30 to minus 80, where the minus 80 will be reached, and at this point you need to put the scale or the sensor knob. To setting up the sensor at the minus 80 mm, we need to consider this point, the 30 mm point is 0 for the first coil. Now use a scale and put the scale at 80 mm with this 0 position, and this is our minus 80 mm point at the 0. So we need to completely adjust the sensor parallel to the 0 point. So sensor is now at the minus 80 mm distance. At this distance we can check the readings, what is showing, which is approximately 21 here for this on the scale. So this is the stand position 21, and this is the sensor position minus 80 mm. Now as we place our sensor to the 80 mm distance, you can use up to change the sensor distance to be on the round figure. So I have adjusted the sensor stand to the 210 mm. So my reading of the sensor stand will be start from 210 mm, and sensor is most probably on the 82 or 83 in the minus. So at this point, using the zero adjusted knob, we have to make the Gauss meter about zero. So our measurement will be starts from this point. Carefully adjust the knob. So our meter is now zero. Now we have to provide the current to the coil 1, which is connected to the constant current source, and we need to provide the current up to 500 milliamps. And as I providing current, the magnetic field is generated around the coil, and you can see the magnetic field intensity in Gauss is also displayed on the Gauss meter. Now we have considered our sensor is at minus 80 mm point, so we have to take the reading of magnetic field on the Gauss meter of every 5 mm interval up to plus 280. So we need to take around 200 readings from up to 500 mm. So we can check the magnetic field from different, or the we can see the effect or the variation of the magnetic field with the distance using this. So we need to take the reading here. Use a paper, or the observation table is also given in the user manual you can use. So our sensor position is minus 80 mm for now, and the stand position, I am considering the stand position because we only move the stand, so sensor position will be accurate accordingly. So stand position is 210 mm right now, and at this time the magnetic field is 10.5 Gauss. So you can see the magnetic field at this time is 10.5 Gauss in the meter also. Now we will move the sensor 5 mm farther from the already distance. So we have moved the sensor to the 215 mm. At this time the sensor is 5 mm lesser, so the sensor is at minus 75 mm, and stand position is 215 mm, and the Gauss meter reading is right now 11.3 G. Similarly, you need to increase up the readings for every 5 mm. We take some more readings. This is 22 or the 220 mm, At this time, the sensor position should be minus 70 mm. Stand position is 220 mm. And reading of the Gauss meter is 11.9 Gauss. So similarly, you can take the readings up to 280 mm for plus. So minus 80 mm to 280 mm, we need to take all the readings till plus 280 mm. The sensor position can be adjusted accordingly and the Gauss value will be taken from the 280 mm also. When you take all the readings and then you put this on a graph paper, and when you draw the graph from coil 1, so you will get from, this is the x-axis at which we have take the readings of the scale with the x-axis along, and the magnetic field value is given here at this y-axis, and the magnetic field graph for coil 1 should be resemble this accurately. When you do the experiments on the coil 2, similarly using the position, and when you get the graph like this, and then you use the both coils, so put the selector switch on the both position. Right now we are doing on the first position, then when you working with the coil 2, put this to the 2 position, and when you work with the both coils, put this to the both position. So this is for the both readings, and now we will check the distance of the distribution of the magnetic field with both the coils approximately on the distance between the coils should be accurately about the radius of the coil. Now for second section of this experiment, we need to move the sensor farther, and the coil 2 should be at the 112 mm farther from the 0 point or the 30 mm point. So from 30 mm plus 112 will be 142. So I have adjusted the coil 2 at the 142 position and properly tightened with the screw on the scale. So you will get the distance between both the coils is approximately equals to the radius of the coil. Now put the coil knob to the position 2 so that you can take the readings of only, and the magnetic field is only generated around the coil 2 right now, and the provided supply is 500 milliamperes. At this, similarly you adjust the sensor as the as we do the coil 1, put this to the minus 80 mm and take the readings. So we are using the scale, so minus 80 mm is approximately about the 60 mm from here. So we'll put the sensor about 60 mm. Then similarly on the, as the last practical, we will take the readings at every 5 mm interval, and then we make the graph between the distance or the x-axis, distance at the x-axis and the magnetic field at the y-axis. Then you plot the graph, you will get the graph accordingly to the coil 2. Now after taking all the readings with the coil 2 experiment, now we are going to do and check the distribution of magnetic field using both the coils. For this, put the selector switch knob at the both position, so you can check the intensity variations accordingly, and you can take all the readings for minus 45 mm to plus 75 mm for this experiment, and then plot the graph between the sensor distance in mm and the magnetic field in Gauss. So when you put the all readings in the graph, you will get the coils at distance of radius A. So this is how you do the experiments for different practicals. Now for second experiment, we will study the axial variation of the magnetic field due to both the coils when the distance between them is less than equal to or more than the radius of the coil. The procedure is as follows. For this, we will fix the distance between the coils and put the coil knob at the position 3 as the last practical, then take the readings from the distance at every interval of 5 mm, and we will change the distance between the coil and then repeat the observation. For typical variation of the magnetic field for a distance between the coils is equals to 0.75A, which is the radius of the coil, and 1.25A is shown in figure also. So when we put the coil, the radius of the coil is 112 mm. For we will take the readings on the radius as well for both the coils, then we take the readings up to 112 × 0.75 at this position, and also we will take the readings for the less than the radius. This is the less than the radius and this is the more than the radius. For this we will multiply the 112 to 1.25, then we will take the readings at that different points. So the adjustment of these values can be vary according to scale wherever you want to set the coils, and you can take the readings for both the type of positions. Now as we have calculated the positions, 112 is our radius of the coil, and when we multiply this 1.75, the 84 mm is the result, and when we multiply the 112 from 1.25 is 140 mm the result. So we need to set the distance between the coils first 184 mm, then we take the readings at 112 mm distance between the coils, and then we take readings on the 140 mm distance between the coils. Right now coil is set on the 112 distance. For 84 mm distance from the first coil, the first coil is at the 30 mm position. Then we use calculator for the approximate value. Now when we take the readings from 84 mm distance, so our second coil should be at the 114 mm. So we'll move the coil to 114 mm. So this is 110, 11, 12, 13, and this is approximately 114 mm. So properly adjust the coil at the distance of 114 mm. Now the distance between both the coils is 114 mm. So at this point we can take the observation and the readings. Similarly as the first experiment, we need to take the readings from minus 45 to plus 175 mm. Then you put all the readings in the graph, then we check the distance and the graph. And for the second experiment, you need to put the coil, second coil, to the distance from first coil is up to 140 mm. So we will press 30 plus 140, which is 170 mm. So we need to put the coil at 170 mm for the second experiment. When we take the readings from farther distance between the radius of the coil, so we have set the coil at 170 mm. Now again take the readings from minus 45 to plus 45 at every 5 mm interval, then you get all the readings in the observation table. For test purpose we have taken all the readings in the manual also. You can take your own readings to verify all the positions of the sensor. Similarly at every 5 mm you can take the readings, then the graph will be plotted like this. So this is the graph of experiment 1 after the old readings, and this is the old readings of experiment 2. So this is the readings at 114 mm distance between coils, and this is at 142 mm distance of the coil. For 0.75A and 1.25A, and these are the old readings, and graph should be resembles like this. So when the distance is 140 or 114 mm for the 0.75A, or the distance between coil is 84 mm to be exact. The graph should be like this, and at the radius of the distance between the coil, both the coils is approximately about the radius of the coil, the graph should be A. And 1.25A, which is the distance between the coil is more than the radius, or to be exact 1.25 of the radius, is the graph like this. So these are the three graphs you will get after taking all the readings. Now we move on to the third experiment. So we now going to perform the experiment 3. In this experiment, only coil 1 is used. So we will place the coil near about and put the selector switch to the coil 1. So we are only required coil 1 here. Now put the sensor at the center of the coil. Now sensor should be approximately in the center of the coil 1 here. You can use the scale or any of the linear material so that you can check the center around the coil. The sensor should be in the center of the coil properly for the accurate results. Now change the current from 0 to 500 milliampere in steps of 50 milliampere and then check the magnetic field. So we will decrease the current of coil 1 to 0. Now increase the current 50 mm first. Also make sure when you zero the current from the coil, the gauss meter should also be at 0. At every experiment, make sure the gauss meter should be start from taking the magnetic field readings from 0 point. Here both the meters are 0 right now. Our coil sensor position is at the sensor center of the coil. Now we'll increase the current 50 mm in steps of 50 mm. So first this is 50 mm. At this point the intensity of the coil or the magnetic field around the coil is 1.4. Now again increase the reading for 100 mm for next 50 mm. The intensity is increasing 2.5. Similarly for 150 mm, 4.4 for 200 milliamperes, 5.7 for 250 milliamperes, 7.1 for 300, 8.5 and 350 milliamperes, 9.9, 400 milliamps, 11.3, 450 mm, 12.7 and 500 milliamps, 14.1 gauss. So take all the readings for different values and put this in the observation table. We have already taken a sample readings for this. Then put the graph between both the readings. So current in the milliamperes is put at the x-axis and magnetic field is put at the y-axis, and you will get a linear graph, because when we increase the current in the coils, the magnetic field increases linearly with the current in the coil. So this is how we calculate the results, and the precautions can also be taken for this. And you should take the no stray magnetic field or ferromagnetic material near about, so that the magnetic field will not disturb due to any of the magnetic field like a screwdriver, any of the metallic object nearby the coil, so that the magnetic field will not disturb and you will get the accurate result. And the zero of the gauss meter should be adjusted, as I told, each time before beginning the experiment, and the verified after completion of experiments to by reducing the current in the coil. So our experiment is complete. So we will verify after reducing the current from the coil, our reading of the gauss meter should be zero. So this is approximately zero. Our experiment and the readings should be equal, and we need to put the or to avoid the interference from the Earth magnetic field, put the complete setup in the east or west direction. Do not put the setup in the north and south, because so you need to put the apparatus in the east or west direction, east to west direction. If you put the apparatus in the north or south direction, the apparatus or the Earth magnetic field will be interfered with this, so that you will not get the accurate results accordingly to the coil current and different values. Earth magnetic field will be interfered in the experiment as well. So we have put the setup in the east or west direction for this experiment. You also, I will suggest you to put the experiment and complete setup in the east-west direction, so you will get the accurate and appropriate reading for the practicals. So this is how we do all the experiments. This is a very simple and easy experiment to carry out all the readings. Just need to take all the readings in 5 mm interval for all types of setup of the coils, and when you use the coil 1 or 2 or both coils, and the current and the Gauss meter should be always to be 0 before starting the setup, and then you calculate all the readings and you can calculate the radius accordingly to the formula given in the user manual. So all the conclusion and all the setup required experiments are given in the user manual. You can use the user manual for proper setup and proper experiment performance. And while doing the experiment with this kit, if you find any difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. Thank you for today.